Hello everyone, myself Deshmukh Madhuri. Today we are going to start one of the most important topic of our syllabus, that is osmosis and diffusion. So before going to start our topic, let us discuss some of the example which are related to our topic concerned biology. So let us start. So friends, you might know that cell membrane is present in plant cell as well as in animal cells too. So how the basically structure is of this cell membrane? So let us discuss here. We can observe here cell membrane, and this cell membrane surrounds every cell. And what is the function of this? We know that it regulates the transport of material in and out of the cell. So basically the structure of the cell membrane is a lipid bilayer structure. So the ball like structure which is shown here on the top of both sides of the tops, that is the hydrophobic head, and the tail like structure which is inside, that is the hydrophobic tail structure. So this is basically sandwich like structure, we call it as a. Now see here, this layer, cell membrane layer, is a two layer structure, that is the hydrophobic head and a hydrophilic tail. And this head consists of chemical compounds, that is the phosphate. It shows the phosphate groups. They are polar and hydrophilic in nature. So basically what is the meaning of hydrophilic? Hydro means water and philic means to love. Along with the phosphate group, the two fatty acids tails are also present, and they are non-polar, and their nature is the hydrophobic nature, means they are water hating, avoids the water. These two layers we can observe here in a given diagram. Outside polar head, so this dotted structure, green dotted structure, showing the polar head, and tail, two tail like structures inward, these are the non-polar tails. Okay. Phospholipids are arranged so hydrophilic means water loving ends face outside, and the hydrophobic water fearing, water hating tails create the interior of the cell membrane. Now let us discuss about the structure of cell membrane. Phospholipid bilayer structure. These transmembrane proteins, cholesterol, that is a type of steroids, glycoprotein and carbohydrate. Anchor cells, we call it as a anchor cells because it create, here I shown in circle, it is called as a, it consists of transmembrane protein, and generally we called it as an anchor cell because it creates the channel for transport of large molecules to pass. Okay. So this yellowish dotted structure, circular structure, I make their circle too with a red color, and this mainly consists of cholesterol. It having a cholesterol, one of the chemical constituent, it maintain, this cholesterol maintain the fluidity of this membrane. Along with cholesterol, phospholipid, glycolipids and carbohydrates are also present, and the major role of these glycolipids and carbohydrates is markers. It act as a markers, means they identify their own compounds and the other compounds, so it act as a marker. It is used for identification. Now let us discuss about the fluid mosaic model. This model is dynamic. Molecules are constantly moving, we can observe here in a given diagram. Okay.
why we called it as a cell membrane is selectively permeable. Now we'll get the answer of this question here. The cell membrane is selectively permeable. So what is the meaning of selectively permeable here? Some of the substances can pass through this cell membrane, but not all. So this is nothing but the selectively permeable. Permeable, it is the ability for something to pass through. So we know that sometime, friends, just wait. Sometime you know that you are also selective. Means, suppose if you don't want brinjal, so you are not interested to eat. Instead of that, if you want another vegetable like methi, fenugreek, so like this, like that, as like we are also selective, no? In means we are having a choice of food, like this. This cell membrane having a choice of substances. The substances which it want, it take inside, and the substances those who don't require, it ban to enter inside this membrane of cell. Okay, so you understand it very well. What is the meaning of selectively permeable? Now let us discuss about the osmosis and diffusion. This is the part of our physiology. Okay, so we know that cell transports the substances. The substances transport into two ways, that is the passive transport and active transport. In passive transportation, there is no need of energy, but in active transport, there is a use of ATP energy. So I shown here in a given picture, that is how the cell membrane act as a selectively permeable. Some of the substances here to the left side of the screen, many substances are present, but the substances which are required to the cells are enters through this membrane, which I shown here by dotted structure. Okay, now next, movement of the substances into or out of the cell without using energy, such kind of the motion is called as a passive transport. And we know that the passive transport occurs from high concentration towards the low concentration. There are three types of the diffusion, that is the simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, and another one is the osmosis. Okay, we have learned that the substances move from the higher concentration to the lower concentration in a passive transport. There is no need of energy at all. But what we do you mean by the concentration? What do you mean by the concentration? You know that. Now let us consider an example. Amount of dissolved in a container, means dissolved substance, amount of dissolved substances or a solute in a container, that is called as a concentration. Suppose if you take a glass of water, and if you add if you take two glass of water, in a first glass of water, if you add a what we called it as a 1 tablespoon of the salt, and in another, in second glass, if you add a bowl of salt, so the second glass is supposed to be more concentrated than that of the first. That is nothing but the concentration. Now let us discuss about the concentration gradient. So friends, as you know that concentration gradient is nothing but the difference between the concentration or amount of something higher to lower. That is the difference between the concentration. Here I have shown here in this box, the dot have the higher concentration towards the left than that of the right. So they begin to move from the left to right. When the concentration gradient is same throughout the area, it is the dynamic equilibrium. As we know that movement of the particles by the process of osmosis, we found that the particles moves from higher concentration to the lower concentration, still they acquire equilibrium. And the point where the concentration gradient is same, means there is no any difference in both area, that is called as a dynamic equilibrium.
particles moving from one side to the other but at the same rate. Now let us discuss diffusion. What is meant by diffusion? Diffusion is when a substance moves from an area of higher concentration to the area of lower concentration. Diffusion will continue until balance or getting or obtaining an equilibrium. For example, if we